而已。
那在祷告前，我们继续来查考《西班牙书》。
Yesterday we talk about God would destroy all the idols in the life of His chosen people.
那昨天我们讲到神会除去在他民中心里所有的偶像。
I want you to turn back to Zephaniah chapter 1.
我请大家翻回西番雅书第一章。
We look at verse 16 again.
我们再看一次十六节。
Verse 16.
十六节。
A day of trumpets and alarm against the fortified cities and against the high towers.
十六节是吹角呐喊的日子，要攻击坚固城和高大的城楼。
So you find that, that here there is a specific target that God would like to destroy.
所以这边有看到这些特别的这些目标是神要来摧毁的。
In chapter 3, verse 6 and verse 7,
在第三章的第六和第七节
we understand that by the devastating all these fortresses and high towers, God would like His people to learn to fear Him.
所以第六节有记载到这些怎样来摧毁这些城楼跟这些高城楼和城邑，就是要让他的百姓来敬畏他。
So that they will receive instruction from the Lord.
所以他们就会来领受神的训诲。
We also mentioned that you know because the people of God are trusted in their own fortresses and their towers are more than God, according to Hosea chapter 8.
那根据何西阿书第八章记载，这些民他们是来依靠他们的城楼来多过于依靠神。
They have forsaken or have forgotten about their Creator, their Savior.
他们确实来忘记了这个造他们的主。
And here it teaching us that you know, if we rely on ourselves, on our strengths or our ability more than God, then you find that God would not be pleased.
那我们在这边可以学到，如果我们来依靠自己，多于神的话，神是这个是不喜悦的，神不喜悦的事。
We also mentioned in Second Kings.
我们在提到这个列王记下。
That you know they actually put these high places in their fortresses.
我们知道他们把这些丘坛也建造在他们的城楼里面。
That's the reason why you know God was very angry and God wanted to destroy them all.
所以神才会那么的生气，想要来摧毁这所有的东西。
We can turn back to 2 Kings chapter 17.
我们可以翻回到列王记下的十七章。
2 Kings chapter 17, we are going to read verse 9.
列王记下十七章第九节。
Also the children of Israel secretly did against the Lord their God things that were not right.And they built for themselves high places in all their cities, from watchtower to fortified city.
第九节，以色列人暗中行不正的事，违背耶和华他们的神，在他们所有的城邑，从瞭望楼直到坚固城，建筑丘坛。
You know, just like we can, you know, derive some teachings from here.
我们可以在这边学到几件事情。
It's like you know, in our life, we do work for God. You know, we.
在我们一生中，我们服侍神的时候
，But one thing we need to bear in mind is that you know whatever we do, we have to ensure that we do it all for the Lord.
那我们要来确认我们服侍神是为了真正来服侍他。
Sometimes in the church, we find that you know we may serve God with an ulterior motive.
那有时候我们在教会服侍神的时候，可能是为了我们自己的益处。
Or we serve God with a hidden agenda.
或者是我们有心中有藏着一些不同的目的。
And we serve God not pure for the sake or for the good of the church. We serve God in order to gain benefits for ourselves.
那有时我们服侍神不是来真正纯洁的心来为了来荣耀神的教会，反而是为了自己。
You find that all this cannot be easily known by ourselves and also people around us.
那有时这种情况对于自己或旁边的人其实是看不出来的。
So according to 2 Kings here, you find that the people or the children of Israel did this secretly.
所以在列王记下这边看到这些以色列人是暗中来行这些事。
That's why we have to ask ourselves this very important questions.
所以我们必须来问自己这个非常重要的问题。
When we serve God, why do we serve God in the first place?
那当我们服侍神的时候，为什么我们当初要来决定服侍神呢？
Is our motive pure before God?
我们的动机是很纯正的吗？
Do we truly serve him for the good of the church?
我们服侍神是真的为了他的教会吗？
So serving God must be selfless.
因为我们服侍神的时候，我们不能有自己太多的想法。
So selfless.
不可以有自己。
Meaning that the I must not be the person who determines how our service must be done.
就是我们不能来决定自己想要怎么服侍就怎么服侍。
So we must follow God's will completely.
我们必须要来随从神的旨意。
There is another reason as to why God wants to destroy the high places. There's one more reason that I can find.
还有一个原因，为什么神要来摧毁这些坚固城？
We turn to Isaiah chapter 27.
我们请翻开以赛亚书二十七章。
Isaiah chapter 27.
以赛亚书二十七章。
We read verse 10.
请看第十节。
Isaiah chapter 27 verse 10.
以赛亚书二十七章第十节。
Yet the fortified city will be desolate, the habitation forsaken, and left like a wilderness.There the calf will feed, and there it will lie down and consume its branches.
第十节，因为坚固城变为凄凉，成了撇下离弃的居所，像旷野一样。牛犊必在那里吃草，在那里躺卧，并吃尽其中的树枝。
There are two things mentioned here.
这边提到了两个事情。
One is the cities or the fortified city will be desolated.
一个是坚固的城会变为凄凉。
And then the second is about, you know, the flock of God or the calf of God will be fed there. 神的羊就。
再来提到那个神的他所造的牛犊会在那里吃草。
Now it's quite a strange scenario here.
这边记载的也蛮特别的。
You know, if you are a shepherd,
如果你是一个牧羊人，
you know, you would not lead your flock to go to a ruinous place.
你不会让你的羊群到一个被离弃的一个地方。
被毁坏的一个地方。
被毁坏的一个地方。
Where there are a lot of rubbles.
就有很多。
Or debris.
很多
破砖
就有很多可能破的砖或是其他的
Because all these things can actually hurt the, you know, the sheep.
因为这些东西可能会来伤害到这些羊群。
Okay, to explain further, I want you to read another similar account.
那为了让大家了解更多，我再跟大家做一个解释。
We read Isaiah chapter 17.
我们再翻以赛亚书十七章。
Isaiah chapter 17.
以赛亚书十七章
We read verse 2 and verse 3.
看第二节和第三节。
Isaiah chapter 17, we read verse 2.
以赛亚书十七章第二节。
The city of Aroah are forsaken, there will be for flocks which lie down, and no one will make them afraid.
第二节，亚罗尔的城邑已被撇弃，必成为牧羊之处，羊在那里躺卧。
This is the judgment against Damascus.
所以这个是对大马士革的这个漠视。
You find that when the cities of Aroah are forsaken,
我们可以看到这个亚罗尔的这个城是被撇弃。
Then the flock will lie down and no one will make them afraid.
那就看到牧羊就成为牧羊之处，然后无人惊吓。
Verse 3.
第三节。
The fortress also will cease from Ephraim.
以法莲不再有保障。以法莲不再有这个坚固的一个城。
Now it seems again, it seems quite unthinkable. We can't really, you know, connect these two together in reality.
所以在现实当中，这样的状况是我们想象不到的。
How can you know you lead your ship to a place where it's desolated, and then you believe that you know the flock will lie down and will not be afraid?
那这是非常奇特，你怎么会让你的羊群到一个荒凉的地方，或者是被撇弃的这个地，然后并没有人能够把它，或者是没有人可以惊吓他们。
So you find that this is the work that God is going to do according to Zephaniah.
所以这是神即将要来做的事情。
We turn back to Zephaniah.
我们请翻回西方雅书。
Zephaniah, we read chapter 2.
请看第二章。
Here, from verse 4 onward, this talks about judgment on Gaza or on the land of Philistines.
在从第四节开始讲这个对加萨的这些审判。
Now I want you to read verse 7.
我想请你们读第七节。
We read from verse 6 and verse 7.
从第六读到第七。
The sea coast shall be pasture with shelters for shepherds and folds for flocks. Verse 7. The coast shall be for the remnants of the house of Judah that shall feed their flocks. Their flock there. 七年。
六节，沿海之地要变为草场，其上有牧人的住处和羊群的圈。这地必为由大家剩下的人所得，他们必在那里牧放群羊。
You find that after God has judged the people, in the land of Philistine.
所以神来咒诅这些在腓利斯地的人。
Destroy the inhabitant there.
就是来摧毁他们的。
And you find that that land will become a place where the sheep of God will lie down peacefully.
然后这个地会变成这些
羊群所
会这些就变成羊群在那边歇息的地方。
So you know, it's like saying that you know, destroy this Philistine first and allow the sheep to go there.
就很像是说，哇，我先把这个腓利斯地来毁灭之后，让我们的羊群再过去。
So I believe we have to look at this from a spiritual perspective.
我相信我们要从这个属灵的角度来看。
If you look at the behavior or the characteristics of the people of the land of Philistine,
我们如果我们来看到腓利斯人这些，我们来看这些腓利斯人。
You realize that they are very aggressive people. They are very fierce.
他们都是非常凶悍的人。
Historically speaking, they always went against the chosen people of God.
那历史上来看，他们常常都在跟以色列人打仗。
So with this perspective in mind,
所以如果有这样子的一个概念的时候，
So you find that in the church, if we behave like the Philistines.
那在教会里面，我们是像这些腓利士人吗？
Then the sheep can never be at, lie down in peace.
然后让这些羊群都不能再安静的歇息。
Sometimes if we want to shepherd the sheep of God in the church,
那有时我要在教会来牧养神的羊。
We may do our best to bring them back, to encourage them to come back.
那我们常常会勉励或者是鼓励他们要常常回来教会。
We find that they just could not come back because of the hostility in the church.
那他们有时没办法回来，因为是教会的。
烟抽嘛，在教会有一些争斗的事情，
就是因为可能在教会有一些争斗的事情。
So God has to do His work by removing the Philistines.
那神就要来出手来摧毁掉这些腓利士人。
And then you find that the sheep will lie down in peace.
你就会发现这些羊群就会安静的歇息。
Now likewise, when you read chapter 2 of Zephaniah, verse 14.
那再请大家看
verse 13 first, yeah.
西班牙书二章的三节。
Verse 13.
是三节。
And he will stretch out his hand against the north, destroy Assyria, and make Nineveh a desolation as dry as the wilderness. Verse 14. The herd shall lie down in her midst.
十三节，耶和华必伸手攻击北方，毁灭亚述，使尼尼微荒凉，又干旱如旷野。群畜就是各国的走兽必落在其中。
Again, historically speaking, Assyria was a very powerful nation.
那这个亚述在历史上来说也是非常强悍的一个国家。
And also very aggressive, towards people whom they have conquered.
那他对他们这些来占领的这些国家是非常的凶悍的。
You find that they show no concern and no care at all to these people.
他们是非常冷血无情的。
That's why God also has to remove the Assyria.
所以同样的，神也要来摧毁这个亚述。
Only then the herd shall lie down in her midst peacefully.
然后一直到这些群畜就是能够在其中来歇息。
So sometimes we find that there are Assyrians in the church.
有时候我们看到可能会有亚述的人在教会里面。
We could be one of them.
我们可能是其中的一个。
Even though we try, you know, to bring the ship back to the fold, we realize that it's difficult.
那但我们其他人如果试着要努力的把这些羊带回教会是非常难的。
If we want the lost sheep to come back,
如果我们想要让这些迷失的羊回来教
会 then we have to change ourselves.
我们必须要首先来改变自己。
Now we turn back to Isaiah chapter 27.
那我们请翻回到以赛亚书27章。
Isaiah chapter 27.
以赛亚书27章。
We read, look at verse 10 again.
我们再看一次第十节。
Here it talks about destroying the fortified cities and to forsake the inhabitants.
这边有讲到这个坚固城，成为荒凉地方。
So that the calf will feed there.
然后牛犊必在那边吃草。
Now, like what we said before,
就像我刚讲的。
If we do things in the church only for ourselves,
如果我们在教会里面服事是为了我们自己。
You find that the presence of God will not be felt.
我们知道这个神的
存在就信徒就感觉不到。
那我们就会感觉信徒就会感觉不到神的存在。
So if this is the case, then you find that members will begin to leave the church.
你就会看到信徒们就会开始离开教会。
Yes, we need the abiding presence of the Spirit in the church.
当然我们要有神的灵跟教会同在。
We also believe that His Spirit is with the church.
那我们也相信神的灵是跟我们同在的。
But what is important is that we must allow the Spirit to rule in the church.
但最重要的是我们要让这神的灵来掌管这个教会。
And so the Spirit can only rule in the church when everyone is willing to do things truly for God.
那当神的灵来掌管这个教会的时候，信徒们必须要来。
人所做的一切事情，那是为主而做，神就来掌管。
就是如果我们信徒做事是为神来做的话，那神的灵就可以来掌管我们这个教会。
So I think it is important for us to destroy our own fortified cities if we have built them for ourselves.
那我们很重要的是，我们必须要来摧毁我们如果心中有建立起这些城楼的话。
Sometimes in the church you find that people do things not truly for God.
我们知道有时候我们在教会服事不是真正为神来做。
And as a result, we form different cliques and different groups in the church.
所以我们在教会就有不同的分支。
You know, it's important. Sometimes we need to have groups in the church.
有时候我们很重要。
需要有那个小组。小组。Groups.
我们知道在教会里面，做工会有会分很多的小组。
You know, if we all do things to please God, yeah, and for the good of the church.
那如果我们都是为了教会来做。
Then we find that all these groups will not cause any division in the church.
那这些小组里面就不会在教会里面来真的来分派。
We realize that if our motive is not correct.
那如果我们的动机是不对的。
Then we can form many groupings in the church.
那其实
which are harmful, yeah, to the church.
那反而在教会里面，我们的这些纷争结党的话，是来伤害教会的。
And we realize that God is going to destroy all this.
那我们也知道神就会来摧毁这些。
Surprisingly, you find that this is mentioned quite a number of times in the prophetic books.
那这个很奇特的这件事情在旧约里面都提到很多次。
Just let you look at another example.
那我们来看另外一个例子。
We turn to Micah.
我们请看弥迦书。
We turn to the book of Micah chapter 5.
弥迦书的第五章。
Again, here God says that He's going to, you know, judge the people.
在同样的神又在这边要来审判这些人，审判人。
I want you to read chapter 5, verse 11.
我想请你们读第五章十一节。
I will cut off the cities of your land and throw down all your strongholds.
十一节也必从你国中除灭城邑，拆毁一切的保障。
We know that strongholds refer to like hiding places.
我们知道这个保障就是一个我们要去躲藏的一个地方。
So you find that the intention of God is very clear.
那我们知道神的这个目的是非常清楚的。
To destroy their cities and their strongholds.
就是要除灭这些城邑和摧毁这些保障。
So today we need to ask ourselves those questions.
所以今天我们要问自己一个问题。
Yes, we serve the Lord in the church. We are building, you know, cities and strongholds.
Yeah, 我们在教会服事时，我们来建造这些城墙。
If our motive is correct,
如果我们动机是对的
，Whatever we do will be pleasing in His eyes。
那我们所做的，在神眼中都会得到神的喜悦。
So we hope that we can be reminded of serving God with a pure motive。
所以我们希望大家都能够被提醒，在我们服事的时候都有正确的动机。
Now we are going to pray。
现在我们要一起来祷告。
So we ask our brothers and sisters to come to the front and to pray。
那我们请弟兄姐妹来到前面一起祷告。